Hello, welcome back to this new video, and today I have a tutorial for you, and it's the tutorial about for this 3x3 full flush seamless glass door. Yeah, and I just say let's jump right into it. Now, for your materials, you will need the following. You will need a stack and eight of your door blocks, big like the blocks you want in the walls right here. Keep in mind that 9 of those need to be pushable, and some of these can't be must be solid and can't be transparent. But we will get there later. You will need your 9 glass, obviously. And for the redstone part, you want 207 different blocks to build on. If you don't want to color code them, that would make 3 stacks and 17. If you do want to color code, however, you will need 1 input block circuit, whatever, 23 brown for the pushers. Yellow is for the piston tape, you will need a stack and 8. Light blue half a stack is for the top 3 triple piston extenders. 16 purple is for the one ticking of the wall. 16 cyan are needed for the middle 2 triple piston extenders. And 33 blue blocks are needed for the lower triple piston extender. You will also want one button, or at least you need an input which is not a lever and is at least 2 ticks long, because there is already a monostable built in. As long as you give it a not one tick pulse, it will always act like a T flip-flop in opening and then closing and whatever. You want 23 redstone torches. You want 87 redstone dust. You want you will want to have 67 repeaters, 49 sticky pistons, 36 normal pistons, 23 comparators, and 10 redstone blocks. You also will need 4 immovable blocks. This can be anything from bedrock to furnaces to chests, but don't use chests, because in 1.10 chests will be pushable, which I completely hate, by the way. You will need 21 slabs or glowstone or stairs, transparent blocks which can be redstone placed on. That sentence was messed up. And you will need pusher blocks. Now these need to be pushable. That's basically the whole purpose. I just color-coded them because why not? You will need 3 in the brown circuit and 13 in the yellow circuit. And other than that, you will need 2 furnaces, 5 cauldrons, and water to put into those cauldrons. Now, you might already have noticed the second chest, because this is the chest for the droppers and hoppers. Yes. You will need 10 droppers, 10 hoppers, 10 random items which are stackable up to 64. You will also want to have 15 of unstackable items. These are necessary, these have to be unstackable items. Just do wooden spades, shovels, whatever. Leather boots, I don't know, whatever you have flying around which is not stackable, it's important. And you want 28 smeltable items and whatever powering, so whatever fuel you want for your furnace, 4 coal will do the job. And yeah, it's a bit complicated. We will get to it eventually. And by the way, of these unstackable items, one needs to be a fuel source, so any wooden tool will do, So one of these has to be a wooden tool, because we will put it in the bottom furnace slot. And one of these can be basically something, just anything else. Like, the only really important thing is one smeltable fuel item. And yeah, I already have them right here on just clicking it in, whatever. And this is your floor level. You will need to dig down three, well, it's full flush, so there is no floor level. But yeah, the redstone extends three blocks under the door frame, three to the left, six to the right, and three above it. And basically that. Your wall, of course, is in front of here. I did not include it. And I will start this tutorial off a little different than usual, because I will start with the circuit which would be fired lastly, and go backwards, because it's way easier this way. So we're going to start with the dark blue circuit, which will fit right into this back corner right here. So you want to start off by placing four blocks like this, with redstone torches on top, except for this one has one on the side. And you have four blocks beneath, or diagonal, with more torches on it. You want a solid floor block above this torch, with another torch, like this. This is necessary to be a solid block. And behind this you want to create this shape of blocks. You want to have a 2-tick repeater right here, a 4-tick repeater right here, and two regular repeaters right there. Connect all of this with redstone dust and place a slab at the end, like this, because there will be a dropper hopper monostable with a random item in it, which is it does not matter which item it is, as long as it is an item, going into a comparator, into a 4-tick repeater, into another 4-tick repeater, and those are connected by a block. And for the for powering this circuit, we will want two blocks like this, a repeater on the top of this, one block here, one block here with redstone dust, two blocks with a 1-tick and a 4-tick repeater, one redstone torch to power the dropper hopper monostable, one block right here to cut off the redstone from purple, which will follow, a block right here with a redstone dust right here, and then a two blocks and one up. These will be a 1-tick and a 4-tick repeater. And that is your dark blue circuit done. Up next is the purple circuit, at least one half of the purple circuit. So you want to get your purple blocks, of course. And right here underneath your door frame, you want to place five blocks like this, with redstone dust on these, and comparators on these. These comparators will power these blocks with torches on top. And these torches will need solid wall floor blocks above it. And there's also one right here, because this one will be powered from here, and the comparator will be right here. Now connect these up with redstone dust. And yeah, the last thing you need to do is place a block, a 2-tick repeater, and a block with redstone, as well as a piston, a sticky piston with redstone block on its face. And right here I see I made a mistake in the dark blue circuit, because the dark blue circuit does not need a block right here. it needs a block below and a redstone dust on the top. Excuse me for that mistake. Now, this is one half of the purple circuit, and the other half will be on the top, but because the top will be, or at least yellow will follow later, I will not do that actually and leave this unfinished for now. I will continue with the cyan circuit, because it's makes sense to do it now, because otherwise you will have to struggle with placing blocks in locations hard to reach, especially in survival. So you want to place two blocks right here, with a repeater and a redstone dust, like this. That's also a reason why this needs to be solid. And going from bottom to top, we will start off with a block right here, with a comparator on it. This comparator goes into a block with a dropper hopper monostable on it, like this. This dropper hopper monostable will take an output into this direction, as well as this block, which is in behind the comparator, and another dropper hopper monostable to power that comparator. Okay, it's in there. Because this will do the couple of final pulses we need. Next up is a block in front of here with a redstone dust going into 2 3 tick repeaters, like this, going into a block, going into a solid wall block. This needs to be solid. And now you want to place a block right here with a 2-tick repeater on top, a slab above the drop-hopper monostable, a piston in front of the 2-tick repeater and above the redstone dust with a redstone block on its face. And we're almost done for this circuit. We will only need to build a piston facing upwards with a cauldron on its face, and that cauldron needs to be filled with water. It does not matter on which level the water is, as long as there is water in the cauldron. Place a comparator and a 4-tick repeater in front of it, or after it. On this block needs to be a 4-tick repeater, and on this block needs to be a block with a torch. Yeah, don't mind that, that's supposed to happen. There's a block right here with a comparator, and there is a torch on here with a block and another block like this. This block will have a 4-tick on it. There is another block up here, and a piston with the second cauldron under it, and if you put water in there, everything should look okay and turned off, at least from this side. And that's cyan done. And this does 2 triple piston extenders, and the dark blue does 1 triple piston extender. The other 2 triple, other 3 triple piston extenders are all handled by light blue. But before we do a light blue, now would be a perfect time to place in your remaining floor blocks, because, well, better now than never. And every other floor block can be transparent, so, and it does not need to be pushed. So you can place, I don't know, maybe, don't do redstone blocks, don't do it. But you could place glowstone or anything right here, as well as these blocks. But don't fill anything else yet, because we will now begin with the bottom half of yellow. And to start off with yellow, we will need 2 normal pistons down here, and place obsidian in these spots, Those are the four immovable blocks. You can of course put furnaces or something. Place two sticky pistons right here with redstone blocks on their faces. And two more sticky pistons right there. Place two regular pistons up here. And redstone dust on this. Now this will power, this is completely fine because we will now cut it off again. And then everything should look like this. And yeah, make a platform down here with one block up here. I have no idea how to describe this shape. Whatever. Place a 4-tick repeater on this, a 2-tick repeater, and a 2-tick repeater, and three redstone dusts. And in these two corners will we be putting a two monostables like this. A torch on this yellow block, going into a comparator, a 4-tick repeater, and I think you can guess what is going to happen now. That's right, a dropper hopper monostable. And yeah, that's really it for this corner. In this corner we will put a block right here, and five blocks like this. Now we want redstone like this, a 2-tick and a 3-tick repeater, a sticky piston with redstone block on its face, and come to this redstone dust right here, place a 4-tick repeater, going into a block, going into a redstone dust, going into a sticky piston with a block on its face, going into a 3-tick repeater. And this is basically everything in the bottom done, like underneath the floor level. And we will move, or I will move on to the brown circuit, which is the pushers on this side. To start off with the brown circuit, we will want to have on the ground level, or above the ground level, so on this hopper, we will want, I'm just noticing that I say some words a lot. There need to be 9 pistons in this corner. It's in the corner and one above the floor level. And behind that you want to place 9 more, but pushed over by one, because we will fill the gap with a staircase going up with slabs. And that needs to be one lower. Like this. Going into a block, going into this W shape, which will be filled with 2-tick repeaters. And excuse me for one moment. Sorry about that interruption. We are back, or I am back. And we will, or I will, I don't know, I'm just saying we will a lot lately. I made a mistake right here. This slab needs to be a solid block, because we will input to this like this, and then it would not travel down if it would be a slab. Create another W shape over here, and 2-tick repeaters in the middle again. And on here we need a 5 long strip, again pushed over by one on here, with a zigzag pattern of 2-ticks and redstone dusts. And that is it for the brown circuit. The only thing left is the pushable blocks in here. I'm using brown glass for it. That brown then, the only thing we can add to purple now is a... Hold on, something is wrong here. This one needs to be shifted over by one. Like this, so a 2-tick and then another 2-tick. Because there will be a piston with a redstone block and a normal piston to update the redstone block piston down here. And now brown is done. And I've been informed that I have now dinner to eat, so I will make a quick seamless cut right here. With even though the redstone particles over there will give it away that it was a cut, and me talking about it also gives away that it was a cut. So I will just look up and then I'll cut and then you hopefully won't notice the cut. So, did you notice the cut? let's just continue with more of the yellow circuit, because the yellow circuit is not even close to be done, as you can see. And next up we will need a slab right here, so we don't power this piston accidentally. Sorry, with a 4-tick on the slab, going into a block, going into another 4-tick repeater, going into a block with redstone on the face. And that goes up into a block powering the brown circuit. And this is powered by this block. And this block is powered by this 4-tick repeater. And this 4-tick repeater is just powered by this redstone dust. Or these redstone dusts. Now there will be a wall block right here, and in case that is solid, we will also want to have a block right here with a tripwire hook. I forgot the tripwire hook. I am an idiot. Well, sorry for that. We also need a tripwire hook. Or a detector rail. If you want to place a detector rail, just place a block right here and put the rail on top. I'm so dumb. And you could also place a block with a repeater like this. Or something, just redirect this redstone, okay? I'm pretty sure you're smart enough to figure out a way. Again, sorry. And from this redstone dust, go into a block with another redstone and into a 2-tick repeater, going up into a slab. Now for the input to this circuit, there is a block right here with a comparator, going into a block with a torch on the face. Just remove this redstone for now, because we will place a dropper hopper monostable right here. Actually an inverted dropper hopper monostable. And then place one again. This has to be unstackable. This has to be a stackable up to 64 items, so this will only put signal strength of 1 out. 2 would be fatal in this situation. Place a 2-tick repeater right here, place another 2-tick repeater right here, and place a slab with redstone dust right here. Now here is a a monostable, and behind that monostable is your input block. So this is your input block. I am so confused right now. This is your input block. And from this piston monostable, we also want a 2-tick repeater facing to the side, like this, into a block, going into the circuit, which we will build in just 1 second. But first we want to extend this slab staircase by two or three, and I'm not sure. No, wait, actually just by two slabs and into a block like this. This way this line will be powered three times. The first one is here, second one is here, and third one is all the way at the end. Come over with a slab and a redstone dust going into a one tick repeater, going into a block, going into a sticky piston facing upwards with another cauldron, number three, I think. And that water just went nowhere. Like this. And we will take an output from this cauldron with a comparator. Of course, what else? Into a block, into redstone dust. And there is another redstone dust, but on a slab here. One tick repeater. Two one tick repeaters. And two blocks, like this. What this will do, it will power this pusher right here. And yeah, this is pretty much the first part of yellow. The second part will be built soonish. Soonish. Because a redstone, put a redstone dust up here. Put a one tick repeater going into a dust, going into a block. And this block powers this piston, and this dust powers this piston. Both have redstone blocks on their face. These redstone blocks will actually power the counterpart of the bottom, being these two pistons facing downwards. And you can already go ahead and fill in your pushable blocks, like right here. 8. And yeah, I'm saying a lot of end. Whatever. This is the first part of yellow done. The second part will be built later or after the second half of purple. So grab yourself your purple stuff again. Place a normal piston here, where the redstone block will be pushed under it. You will need a pushable set of wall blocks onto a redstone block, and this redstone block is in this state powering this redstone dust. Okay, this redstone dust will then power this slab and this slab, and there is a normal piston facing downwards right here. This is the same as this down here. This is a dual-edged monostable. As not dual-edged, but when we power this, this will blink off for one tick, and when we power this, this will blink off for one tick again. And we will need that to power the top. Basically everything. I was about to say top shit, but no. This goes into a torch, and you need a bunch of solid ceiling blocks now, because you will need one here with a three tick repeater, you will need one here with a comparator on subtract mode, we will need one here with a normal comparator, and then we will need these ceiling blocks also need to be solid, and fill everything right here with redstone dust. Now, again, the rest can just be filled in with any wall block you like, except redstone blocks. Don't do it. Not this block, actually. This block needs to be solid as well. But other than this and this, our wall should be, or our ceiling should be done. Because right here, on this comparator, here comes the important or complicated or complex shit. Because we will have a furnace right here with 28 smelten items in it. Because we need to fill every slot in here to subtract a signal strength of 12. Because this will get a 15 pulse from the back, and we will subtract 12 from it. Now the problem is that this needs to be a solid block, because reasons will be obvious later. And this furnace is the only solid block which can be comparatored while still being solid and not spitting out items when done. The other would be a jukebox, and let's face it, you're not going to put a jukebox with the correct music disc in it. Because that's just hilarious if you would do that. And this is way easier and resource friendly. Yeah, from here we will actually, this needs to be a solid block as well. We will place a one tick repeater going into the light blue circuit. The light blue circuit will fill everything right here. So you want to place a block right here with a sticky piston facing downwards, with a cauldron on its front, and put water in the cauldron. Now, either you place the cauldron down here, or you need to one tick this piston. If you do that, just wrap yourself a lever, whatever, place it on this block, and click two times really quickly. Or just destroy the cauldron and replace it. But my mistake, you need to have it down here. Because we will take a output from it, and it should be off by default. So this goes into a block, and this goes into another block with a 4 tick repeater going into two slabs like this, going into another block with a 3 tick repeater on its face, going into a subtract mode comparator, and again we will subtract something from it, but this time we will subtract not a solid, nothing solid. We will be changing what we subtract, because on default we are going to subtract 12. So it leaves a 3 tick, or a signal strength of 3 through, but we need to resist to have a monostable built in. So we will place a slab right here with two 4 tick repeaters, and this will then spit out an item into the hopper, which will then turn a signal strength of 15, and then it's going to subtract everything, and then there's no output. Because in this dropper, we will place our 9 unstackable items. This is why we needed so many. And in the hopper, will be 4 more. So you will have 13 unstackable items in this dropper hopper circuit. And this should be on now. And now you can fill in everything in the walls and ceilings, except that block and these 6. Because, well, yeah, I need a sticky piston. Okay, thanks. From here on out, you want to place a torch here, with another torch right here, with a block into a 2 tick repeater, going up into another block. And just leave that there for now, You want to place four blocks right here with redstone dust on its face, top. And you want to also place four blocks right here. And four blocks on these four blocks. So you have this line four deep. And on these four blocks, you want to place four comparators. Because now we will be taking four drop hopper monostables right here. And in every one of these will be an unstackable item, a stackable up to 64 item, like this. And I just now realized these need to be one deeper, so undo everything. We need to place these one deeper, of course, otherwise this would make no sense. So down here, place these, and then put one a stackable up to 64 item into it. 16 might work as well, but just to be safe, put a random dirt, a random cobble, a random stick, a random wood, something worth laying around into it. This will be super useful because it allowed us to give every block of these a single strength of 1, meaning we won't bud anything. This is super useful. And come back to over here. Place a redstone dust on these two with a 2-tick repeater in the middle. You need to hold shift to and then right click to place something on hoppers in case you didn't know. Now you also want to come to over here, place a block right here with a sticky piston like this, going into a 1-tick repeater, going into a block, going into another 1-tick repeater like this, going into a 2-tick repeater to the side, this is on the furnace by the way, and place an updater piston to the side. And if you are this far, this furnace should probably already have smolten, I don't know, all 28 items. Don't take them out, don't do it. Because we want to place, we completely fill this, so either place 64 items of coal or anything, and something like here, or just put stuff like to here, and don't put the same, like in this case, don't put cobble here so it does not smelt continuously. I think you're smart enough, you need to have 28 items in the right slot and completely fill out these two. Because then this will give a single strength of 12. And yeah, so now we basically continue with our light blue circuit, or finish up the light blue circuit. Place a block up here with two repeaters. A block, two blocks, and two-tick repeaters, if I am not mistaken. No, three two-tick repeaters. And yes, these need to be two-tick repeaters. You cannot place two three-ticks or one four-tick and one two-ticks, because there needs to be a two-tick pulse going through this piston. Because this piston will be pushing this block to here, and then will allow this repeater to power this redstone dust. And the way we will power this repeater constantly is by placing it like this, like turn it on. Then you want to get yourself a comparator and your second furnace, and just put any random item into the furnace. That will lock this repeater. You can of course place a repeater and a redstone block or lever, or don't put a lever. Just do it like this. It's way more resource friendly anyways. And now is the perfect time to finish up yellow, because yellow is not done yet. Grab yourself your remaining pushable blocks from the yellow circuit, or if you don't color code in general, place them up to here. They should reach exactly to this redstone dust, because on here we will place a cauldron with water inside, like this. And we will take an output from this cauldron to the left from this perspective into a one tick repeater into a block with redstone, no, with a piston on it, on top of it, with a redstone block, because this redstone block will basically push the whole tower back down. And that's why it's important that we put that we don't put any longer signal on here, because this this will get pushed up for 4 ticks, and as you can see here, this won't work because it's can't push, but it will be updated by dust flying around here so that it will work eventually. So now grab yourself more yellow blocks. Place a slab right here with a comparator, which will take an output from this cauldron, going into a monostable with a 3-tick repeater, into a torch tower. This torch tower is not really a torch tower, it's just one torch. But psh. Yeah, take a 2-tick repeater output from this torch into a block, into another inverter, and this torch will update this piston. And place a block, two blocks right here, 2-tick and redstone dust. This 2-tick will have a block in front of it and a redstone block to the side, a wool block with redstone dust on the top to the side. This will push back down this stuff. But yeah, you also want to place a torch here. And then just drag this out like this into a block at the end. And place two normal pistons right here. So this will be the other way of the sliding circuit. And we are almost done. We need to, because there is a really, really annoying bug. If you if this cauldron gets moved, okay, on servers or on the redstone now where we built it, we had to place a comparator right here to update the comparator, because usually comparators don't notice when a cauldron gets moved two blocks away from them. If you're on a, just place that comparator right there to be safe. I'm surprised this actually worked, to be honest. Just place it and be safe in that case. Now this piston gets pushed down by this redstone block, or this piston activates by this redstone dust, but that is actually not well timed, because it's not timed at all. So this is just a weird coincidence that it powers it to push this stuff back down at the correct timing. We will need a nor an updater piston, so when this piston extends, this one that notices it. So this piston will also power this pushing back down, firing everything again. And if I am not mistaking, again, this should be everything done. Let me just fly over here for some comparison. We got that, we got that, we got that. We got this stuff, we got all of this down here. Yeah, I think we are ready to give this a go. If, now at this point you want to place in your pistons, or like the pistons which will be doing most of the work. So grab yourself 18 sticky pistons and place them all facing into the hallway like this in sets of three like this. These are our triple piston extenders, and place pushable wall blocks of your choice. No fucking redstone blocks. Don't do it! Like right here. And on the other side we want to place six right here and six up here like this. Grab yourself your glass or glass or stained glass which you want in the in the door or in the wall when it is extended. So place three here and six here and three there, and fill in the rest with your pushable not redstone blocks, wall blocks, and this should be everything done. Okay. Super obvious mistake I made. Get yourself a slab, because we placed, or I placed, one block wrong. This two tick repeater right here needs to be on a slab, and there needs to be redstone dust on this purple block. Yes, that should be it. And once you filled in your wall, you basically have built the 3x3 full flush seamless glass door. So congratulations! If you build it this way and it broke, please just message me, write a comment, and describe exactly what happened, like if there is a block up here pushed out, or if the pistons got pushed over, or something happened under it, and I will be happy to help you fix your problem. And yeah, other than that, thank you for watching, and traditional, wait, this isn't traditional. Much better. Bye.